Oh, won't you say you love me? I'll make you so proud of me.
I'll make them turn their heads every place we go.
Welcome to our show. Tonight, our guests are Ruth Buzzy, Ron Howard,
our brother Jimmy Osmond, and our own Ice Angel.
Almost here, Valentine's Day, and y'all excited about it?
Oh, I sure am. I love holidays.
Do you?
Yeah, I really do.
I mean, it's a terrific time to give presents.
To what?
To give presents. I mean, Christmas giving is all over with, and both of our birthdays are all past, and along comes Valentine's Day to remind us once again of the joy of giving.
You're leaning a little heavy on the word give.
No.
Don't you by any chance mean receive?
Let me tell you something, Marie. In order for person A to give, person B has to receive. You see?
So, this explains the list of new records and small appliances that I've been finding all over the house?
Oops.
Oops.
Oops. I guess I must have left my own personal shopping list around the house and you accidentally found it.
Since when does your personal shopping list read, "Dear Marie, Donnie would enjoy the new Linda Ronstadt and Fleetwood Mac albums"?
Oh, that list!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes. I guess I accidentally dropped that one.
Onto the mirror?
Possible.
Written in soap?
Couldn't find a pencil.
And then there was a note left on my windshield last night. Marie, what time is it? My old, rundown, dilapidated clock is so unreliable.
I didn't want to be late for rehearsal.
Donnie, since when do we rehearse at 10:30 at night?
Day, night, what does it matter? Time is always with us. Time. Tick, 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 tick.
Donnie.
Yes?
I have to tell you something.
What?
I'm not going to get you a clock.
Oh, good, good, good.
And I'm not going to get you any records.
Oh, good. Then I guess you found my third note.
No, I didn't.
Well, it's underneath the toaster. Has something to do with calibrated wrenches.
Donnie, you got to face up to it.
What?
Valentine's Day is not a time for giving of material gifts.
It's not?
No. It's a time for love and for affection.
Love and affection. Well, then I guess you won't want the gift I got you.
You got me a present?
Yep.
It's probably a set of calibrated wrenches.
You peeked.
Just a lucky guess. I'll tell you what.
What?
I will accept the wrenches as the perfect, perfect Valentine gift.
You will?
Yes, I will.
Hey.
In fact, Donnie, they are so perfect.
How perfect are they?
That I am going to give them back to you.
No!
Yes!
You're kidding!
How is that groovy?
Now that's what I call love and affection.
Happy Valentine's Day, everybody.
The science of astronomy defines the sighting of a UFO as a close encounter of the first kind. The landing on the Earth by a space vehicle as a close encounter of the second kind. And physical contact with an alien intelligence as a close encounter of the third kind.
Thank you. Yeah, it's a pleasure meeting you. This is my wife, Helene.
Welcome to our solar system. Do you speak English?
English? No. I speak the language of our planet. We call it Swedish.
And then there is the close encounter of the fourth kind. Taking the aliens to lunch.
Whose voice is that? Friend or foe?
Well, who knows? On our planet, anything can happen. We even have margarine that talks.
Look, it's after 2:00. What do you say we all go for some lunch, huh?
Okay. Nito, it's safe to come out now. The Earthlings are friendly. They offer to spring for lunch. Say hello to the little woman. Now stop speaking Chinese. It's impolite. They speak Swedish.
You must be starved after your trip.
We haven't had anything to eat since Andromeda. And you know how awful flying saucer food is.
Really? heated meteorites and pineapple rings.
Yuck! And after all that, they misrouted our luggage to Venus.
Here we are, piping hot, ready to eat.
Where did you get these wheels?
They think they're wheels. No, no, these aren't wheels. These are called hamburgers.
Hamburgers?
Hamburgers?
Hamburgers.
It's uncanny. They resemble the wheels to our space vehicle.
These hamburgers would go great with a side of fries and a shake.
Even stranger is a close encounter of the fifth kind, fighting over the check.
Boy, that man talks perfect Swedish. What is that piece of paper?
Are you sure that you've never been to Earth?
Never.
Oh, good, good. Look, here's a quaint little custom that I think you're really gonna enjoy. Won't they get a bang out of this?
Oh, yeah, love it, yeah.
Oh, here it comes!
Now, this is where you get to pay the check. It's a great honor among Earthlings.
Pay the check? But we have no money! Oh, don't be so happy.
All right, in that case, then I think I can lend you some until payday.
When's payday?
How should I know? You're the one who's working.
And then there is the closest and most dangerous encounter of them all, leaving the tip.
Good resonance. I'd like to hear him sing sometime.
Okay, look, here's the money that you wanted to borrow to pay the check.
Okay. I'll accept it on one condition.
What's that?
That I get to leave the tip.
Oh. Well, all right. It's a deal. Boy, you really drive a hard bargain.
No, I drive a hard-top saucer.
Well, darling, we had better get started. You have got a long drive ahead.
How far is it?
20,000 light years.
Can I borrow some more money for that tip?
Oh, sure, pal. I mean, what's a good friend for? By the way, when do you think you're going to be able to pay this back?
Next time we visit Earth. Come, Nito. Let's go see Star Wars.
Oh, again?
Yes.
Oh, but we already saw it 5 times.
I know. But this time, we can have buttered popcorn and jujubes.
Oh, honey, can I have goobers?
Jujubes.
Yeah.
of your going. Oh, how could you cut the threads and leave me here behind? But look at windward for my comfort. I take each day.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight I've decided to do something very unusual.
Entertain?
Whoa! You're very sharp tonight.
Thank you, Daddy.
You're welcome. Anyway, tonight you and I are going to discuss the qualities necessary in the ideal guy for you, okay?
We're going to discuss?
That is correct. See, Marie, I'm going to give you the benefit of my added years of wisdom.
I don't want your added years of wisdom.
Okay, first of all, this ideal guy should be tall, taller than you, about my height.
I kind of like shorter guys.
Secondly, he should have dark hair.
Actually, I prefer blonde hair.
And here's the important part. He should be about, 2 years older than you.
1 year's fine with me.
See, this is very valuable for you, Marie. You're verbalizing your likes and dislikes very, very well.
Now, if you really want to do me a favor...
What?
You can trust me to find my own boyfriends.
What?
You can trust me to find my own boyfriends.
Okay.
Huh?
Okay. If that's the way you want it, that is the way you'll get it.
Oh, good!
But
I knew
do
it.
Yourself a favor, all right?
Okay.
When you go out there looking for the perfect guy, find someone who has all the qualities of the big D. You see, Marie, that is what I have been trying to tell you.
Donnie?
Hmm?
I'll be happy if he has just one of your qualities.
Oh, really?
Yes.
And which one?
Your modesty.
Sing, Marie.
I'm a little bit country.
And I'm a little bit rock and roll.
And then you're not.
Cause they have your mind.
just like the rest. The first you reeled me in, found out, worn out, curtain giant, two time and grandin' all. So don't tell me that you mean well. I'm only new, I can tell you're trifling. And you're no good.
Stars out tonight. I don't know if it's cloudy.
Is my thing. Watch me now.
Russian French apple pie with American cheese on the side, a chocolate milk, and a low-fat milk.
It's mine, it's mine. I got
and she'd never get back here.
Oh, my hunger. Hey, wait a minute. I ordered a hamburger on cheese.
No, you ordered the hamburger on cheese, not the cheeseburger with ham.
Oh, you sure?
Sure, I'm sure.
Here's the hamburger with cheese. Now, do you remember my hamburger, medium rare, on the medium side, with a side of ketchup and ketchup on the side?
Just the way you like it.
Oh, I got that by mistake. I ordered Swiss on French with Russian dressing.
No, you ordered Swiss on Italian with Russian French apple pie with American cheese on the side.
Are you sure?
Would I lie to you, boss?
Hey, I'm paying Swiss on Italian with Russian. Now, where's my ham on white? Mustard on the ham.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I thought it was mine.
No, yours is the ham on rye, mayo on the cheese, and a little fat milk right here.
Thanks.
Okay, everybody, now here's your change.
Yeah.
Now you gave me $3.50 and it was only $2.75, so here's your 75 cents change. Then you gave me $3, but yours came to $3.50, but Nancy owed you 50 cents from yesterday, so I took 50 cents off her change. Nancy?
Yeah.
Here's your dollar and a quarter from the five you gave me, minus 50 cents I took to pay Betty's bill.
Thanks.
And since you're broke, as usual, I added $3 more to your tab, which now comes to the total of $17.90. And boss, yours came right to the penny, so we're even.
Well, where's that extra napkin I asked for?
Did you ask for an extra napkin? Gee, I don't remember that.
That's the trouble with you, kid. You never remember anything.
You know, it's not too often that we have an up-and-coming young movie personality on our show.
That's right, and it's even rarer when the brand-new movie star is a member of your own family.
Ladies and gentlemen, our brother Jimmy.
All right! Hey, Jimbo.
Thank you. Now, that's what I call some kind of introduction.
Well, you are some kind of brother, you know, making a movie and all.
Would you like to tell us the name of the film, Jimbo?
Yeah, I'd like to tell you the name of the film was Star Wars, but that was already taken. The name of my film was The Adventures of the Great Brain.
Adventures of the Great Brain, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I hope you're not going to tell us it's your autobiography.
I'd tell you that if I thought you'd believe it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's our brother Jimmy singing the theme from The Adventures of the Great Brain. Go get him, Jimbo.
There's time enough to cry when I run out of smiles and laughter. When living isn't any fun, when every great adventure's done. There's time enough to quit when I've got every dream I'm after. But until then, I'm gonna play and live a lifetime every day. And know that along the way, you're there. When I feel all alone and all my world is tumbling, that anytime I call, you're there. When skies above are gray and rain is falling on my windowsill, the hours seem to almost crawl, but I don't feel alone at all, 'cause I know anytime I call, you're there. Just being what you are, you're a very special kind of friend, and I'm a very lucky guy to know you as I do. Let's stay close together to the seems the sun shines brighter then. You make me feel so good inside, my tiny troubles run and hide. You light up every day, you chase the clouds away and cheer me. There's magic in your simple style, you make my world seem more worthwhile. Your smile, you're there. Ooh. You light up every day, you chase the clouds away, you make my world worthwhile, and when I need a smile, you're there.
remember, you've only got a short time to clean Marie's dressing room. She's using the skater's room until we can get this mirror replaced. So do a good job. Oh, and don't touch anything.
Oh, no, no, sir. You can depend on me.
Remember, Marie will be here any minute.
And I'm a little bit mopping pail. I love it when I'm funny.
Dolly, I'll be on stage in just 1 minute. I just have to fix my makeup.
Okay, but hurry, okay?
Okay,
thanks.
Hurry. Oh, would you look at that? They fixed my mirror.
You better go get changed. It's time for our duet, okay? Let's go.
Oh, there I go. I sure hope I've been proud of my life.
Got the right chemistry.
Yes, when it's right, you know it. There's no doubt, no mystery.
Ooh, baby, I'm sold on you. You're everything to me.
You're everything to me.
Ooh, baby, I'm sold on you.
My never-changing season.
I'd like to tell you the story of how Valentine's Day was invented. Once upon a time, there was a land without love. In fact, it was called Evalon, which is no love spelled backwards. Now, it wasn't really an unhappy place to live, because out of 365 days, 364 of them were holidays. The people of Evalon, under the guidance of their fun-loving mayor, had festivals for everything you could imagine, all year.
I like my calendar girl. Oh, sweet calendar girl. I like my calendar girl. Each and every day of the year. For instance,
January.
It's time for Miss Deep Freeze.
February.
That means Miss Cottage Cheese.
March.
Say hello to Miss Arc Supports.
April.
Welcome Miss Badminton Courts. Yes, yes, my heart's in a whirl. I wanna celebrate each calendar girl every day of the year. May, don't forget Miss Man and the Moon. June, how about Miss High Noon?
July,
that's the month for Miss Salad Fork.
August,
we salute Miss Crown Roaster Pork. Here, here, the girls are all here to help us recollect our favorite day of the year. Every day, special day of the year.
September,
autumn brings Miss Corn on the Cob.
October,
don't forget Miss Out of a Job.
November,
let's bring on Miss Garden Hose.
December,
and last of all, Miss Cold in the Nose. And there you have some of Evalon's best. Those happy, happy holidays that fill us with zest. Every day of the year. Happy Shoes Day!
One lovely citizen of Evalon realized that in spite of the Nose Festival and National Shoe Day and Take Your Laundry to Lunch Week and all the others, she wasn't totally happy. There just had to be more.
One day when I was teeny, just a tot of two or three, my grandma very close and whispered this to me. My child, one day you'll find there's more than earth and sky above. And if you hope with all your heart, you may discover love.
Godmother,
thank goodness you're here. Maybe you could tell me what I was just singing about.
Oh.
I mean, I've never heard of it before, and I don't even know what it means.
Oh, you must mean love.
Yes. Did my grandmama tell you about it, too?
Your grandmama? Oh. Oh, my dear. Love is as old as time.
But what is love?
L is for the way he looks at you. O is for the only thing that's true. B is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can. Love is all this world can give to you. You ain't seen nothing yet.
How about that?
I got love. I got love. I got love. I got love, 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 love. I got love. Go by the hour, cause I got love. Don't be glum, listen chum. Thanks to me, you're a lucky girl. For the first time in your life, you'll be somebody in this world. Bye-bye blues. Woo! You can lose. Got a jar of honey. Every day you're sunny, cause I got love. Now you got love. Sweet, sweet love. We got love, love, love. Yeah, we got love.
What is all this? Don't you know that that word is not allowed in Avalon?
Your Honor, you are beginning to get on my nerves.
Fairy Godmother, if you can have him appear, why can't you make him disappear?
Oh, no, no, no. I've got a better idea. I'll marry him instead. Da, 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 da.
Oh, what a happy event. This must be the most wonderful day of the year.
Yes, my love is spread all over Avalon.
Oh, no, not Avalon. Any longer. As you know, Avalon spelled backwards is no love.
I didn't know that.
And that will never do for our land of love now. So I hereby dub this the kingdom of Valentine.
Valentine!
And I'll name a holiday after it. From now on, we'll celebrate Valentine's Day.
Oh. Good thinking.
Love, love, hooray for love. Who was ever too blasé for love? We've named this day for love. Now there's not enough to say for love. No more we'll fear for love. Now we'll only sing and cheer for love. We pay the way for love. So let's shout hooray. What's hooray for love? What's a you? We found our love in Avalon. Hooray, 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 hooray.
And we all live happily ever after.
Happy Valentine's Day! Hooray!
Yes.
Now that we know how Valentine's Day was invented, are you going to celebrate in any way?
Yeah, I think we should all get together and pass out all the hundreds of cards that we're going to receive in the mail.
Oh, just like always, huh?
Just like always. Uh-huh. One for you, 7 for me, 1 for Jay, 10 for me, 1 for you, 15
Donnie,
for me.
Donnie, there's still one thing that I don't think you understand about Valentine's cards.
What?
They don't count if you send them to yourself.
They don't?
No.
Say goodnight, Marie.
First, we'd like to thank our guests, Ruth Buzzy, Ron Howard, our brother Jimmy, and our own Ice Angels.
But most of all, we'd like to thank you for sharing this evening with us.
May tomorrow be a perfect day.
May you find love and laughter along the way.
May God keep you.
Also appearing on tonight's show was Johnny Dark and Jack DeLeon. This is Wayne Osmond speaking.